My quest is at an end. The mask of the Pharaoh Lidiki is before my very eyes. Speak, O ancient one. Tell me the secret I have been yearning to know.
Where is the sacred lamp?
Stolen from our people so many years ago.
Who are you to be given such privileged information? Are you of the royal bloodline?
Yes, for more than 30 generations we have sought the lamp. I am your direct descendant.
Then you have in your possession the sacred ring.
Yes, I have it here. But what's so special about it, we've never been able to fathom.
Rub it.
I suppose it is, really.
Not rubbish, rub it.
Oh, rub the ring, you mean?
Master, what is thy bidding?
Master? Me?
Why, yes, Master. He who wears the ring is the keeper of the slave.
A slave? But I have many slaves. What can this one do that's so special, I wonder?
Do not underestimate this slave, Abanazar. For one thing he can lead you to is the sacred lamp.
You know where the lost lamp lies? Is this true?
Why, yes, Master, it is thy bidding to find the whereabouts of the lost lamp.
Of course it is, you ninny. My family has searched for the lamp for centuries. Do you mean to say that you have been hiding away in this old ring for all of these years, and it never even occurred to you to come out and tell us that you knew where it was?
Alas, Master, nobody rubbed my ring until now.
Nor that I can believe. Very well, we are wasting time. Take me to the lamp at once.
It is not so simple a task that a mere slave can undertake it, Abanazar. He may lead you to the place where the lamp lies, but you'll need further assistance before you can discover its treasure.
Oh, yes?
Yes, you will need to find a young man by the name of Aladdin.
Aladdin, eh? And where will I find this boy?
The slave will lead you to Aladdin.
He lives far away, across the sea, in a land called China.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's be off.
Be warned, Abanazar. Aladdin is the only one who can own the lamp. He is its rightful owner. He may share its treasures with you, but he would need to be persuaded.
And how did this young Chinese boy come to be the owner of the lamp? What is he to me?
He is your nephew, Abanazar. Your right to the lamp was passed to him when your brother fathered a son.
My brother? A father? I never knew.
Neither did he. He had a scrummage with a young Chinese girl. Nevertheless, it is to him that the lamp and all its treasures now belong.
Master, if we are to reach China before dawn, we need to leave on the next available tide.
Oh, don't worry about getting there, slave. Over the years, I have acquired some pretty impressive powers of my own, too, you know. Once we get to Aladdin's hometown, however, then I may require your assistance. But in the meantime, stay close and watch this. Alakabin, alakabam, to Chinatown as quick as you can.
Thank you. Have you been introduced yet?
No.
Well, come on, everybody. Stand up and shake hands with the person to your left. Yes, left. Why not? Come on. No excuses. Everybody up. Come on. Come on. I mean, what's not worth it, mate? Our children. Oh. Okay, yeah, lovely. Now I say, shake hands, you two at the back. That's all. I mean, dearie me. Public place and all. Okay, yeah, everybody sit down. No, sir, not on a lap. Blimey. Oh. Anyway, let me introduce myself. My name is Willow Trankey. I run the laundry around the corner. Oh, such hard work it is, isn't it, girls? You men have no idea how hard it is to load those machines and then close the door and then turn on the machine. Oh, it's as much as I can do. Oh, when I go to turn on the telly and open a box of chocolate. Oh, I'll tell you. Anyway, yeah, well, I'm a widow as well. Well, my husband was taken away from me many years ago by that young strumpet from down at the post office. She took him to the cleaner, she did. I was so angry when I found out. I threw all his clothes out the window. Trouble is, he was wearing it at the time. Let's show him.
Hello, Mum.
My pride and joy. My youngest son.
Youngest son, Mum. Remember your grandma.
You leave my grandmother out of this.
I'm only saying, Mum, you've only had two sons, me and Aladdin. So he's the eldest and I'm the youngest. If you had another baby, it'll be completely different. Aladdin will be the eldest, I'll be the middle, and your other baby would be the youngest.
Would she? Have you ever wondered why it is they call you daft?
No, Mum. I never had to work that out.
Well, let me enlighten you. It's because you're daft! Well, what are you rattling on about? Me having another baby at my time of life? I wonder where you get your ideas from. I really do.
Ian, Mum, all these people.
Oh, that's the audience. Don't worry about them.
Oh, yeah, that's just it, Mum. They can help me.
Help you? Help you how, exactly? If anything, you need is a psychiatrist. All those stupid inventions of yours.
They're not stupid. Well, not all of them, anyway.
Really, was she, what was it last week? A flame-proof bread, I think?
Yeah, what's wrong with that? It's for people that don't like toast. Well, boys and girls, will you help me?
Yes! Yeah.
Oh, goody! Now this here is my magic microwave. It's where I make all my prototypes, my inventions. Let's see what's inside now. Oh, it's ready! My latest invention.
Well, what is it?
I call this the hot and cold flask. See, it's got two tops, one red and one blue.
So what use is this invention then?
Think about it, Mum. You can either use a flask to keep things hot or to keep things cold. The thing is...
Yes?
How does it know?
How does it know?
How does it know?
Yeah, how does it know?
How does it know? Yes! How does a flask know the difference? If you put cold milk into it, how does a flask know it's not hot milk?
So how does your invention actually help then?
Oh, that's easy. I've tried it and it worked a treat. In the morning, I put cold milk into it and put the blue top on. And then, in the evening, I put hot milk in and put the red top on and it keeps it hot.
But how does the flask know which top you're putting on?
I don't know, but it does.
No, I don't know why either, but anyway, and you still wonder why it is that people call me daft?
Yeah. Well, boys and girls, you're all going to help me, aren't you?
Yes!
Oh, goody! Now, here's what we need to do. Every time within the show, you hear a ping, can you shout out, wishy washy, as loud as you can?
Yes!
Yeah? All right, I don't want you to shout out, wishy washy, as loud as you can. I want you to shout out, wishy washy, okay?
Yes!
Right, I'll go off and have a practice.
Okay, you can.
Oh, come on, boys and girls. You be louder than that. But it's it's ready. My latest invention, if I can find it. Here it is.
Okay, what is it?
I call this the electric dark bulb.
Dark bulb? You mean a light bulb, don't you?
No, watch this.
Oh! Wesley, you silly, silly boy. Turn it off. I mean, what is the use of a stupid invention like that?
Oh, think about it, Mum. You know how all these kids out here won't go to bed in the summer because it's still light outside? Now, they won't have any excuses, will they?
Well, I don't know, but Wishy, you know what? You have the brains of a two-year-old, and I bet he was glad to get rid of them. I've had enough of your stupid inventions for one night. Look, I've got to get back to the laundry. You do me a favour, go and find that brother Aladdin of yours. Yes, and no more inventions. Is that clear?
Oh, okay, Mum.
Electric dark bulb.
Oh, poor Mum. No, it's worse than that, come on. That's better. Poor Mum, you see, she doesn't understand the younger generation, you see.
Hello,
Wishy! Aladdin, where have you been? Mummy's very sick!
Oh, never mind about that now. I've got something to tell you.
Oh, go on.
I'm in love.
In love?
Yes.
What for? I mean, who with?
Oh, so shy.
Oh, I know.
No, that's her name. So shy.
So shy? The Emperor's daughter? Oh, well, Aladdin, do you think you ought to?
I don't have to think. I'm in love. I want the whole world to hear.
Yes, does the fact that anyone looks at So Shy's face versus instant death that he has, the Emperor's guard, make any difference how you're feeling? I'm only asking you to understand, you know.
I'm not frightened of any stupid guards.
Yes, that's half the trouble, Aladdin Twanky. You're not frightened of anything.
Why should I be? I'm in love with a wonderful girl.
Remind you yet again that I am the daughter of an emperor?
I'll tell you what, Pig, we're never going to hear the end of that.
As the daughter of an emperor, I'm entitled to the same rights and privileges as you.
But I keep trying to tell you, darling, I am the emperor, not you.
Ha! Your father was but a mandarin.
Yes, I'm a bit of an old fruit myself.
This is what I get for marrying below my station.
Oh, it's true, you know. We were married on the underground, right below Buckingham Palace.
King's Cross?
Well, wouldn't you be?
And another thing, where is our daughter so shy?
I don't know, darling.
Well, you better find her, and be quick about it. I want to be back at the palace before our guests arrive.
Guests? What guests?
Oh, I've told you a dozen times. This weekend, we are entertaining.
That'll be the day.
Our cousins from Arabia will be arriving in the next few hours.
Oh, you mean, what's it and who's it?
I mean, the daughters of our illustrious uncle, Desert Sunrise and Golden Mountain.
Oh, yes, such pretty names. I wonder how they came by them.
Well, of course, in their country, they're named after the first thing that their father sees at the moment of their birth.
Oh, I see. And what about their brother, the illustrious Camel's Nose? Is he coming too? Hey, good job the camel wasn't facing the other way, is it?
No, sadly, he has pressing business at home.
Oh, he takes in ironing as well.
Now, enough of this gossiping in the street like common peasants. Find so shy and fast.
Oh, but darling, I'm starving. Why should I fast if we're having guests?
It's no use. I mean, find so shy quickly, you fool.
I know what you feel like.
You won't believe this as well, you know? You won't believe this, but when she was younger, she was quite a good catch. Maybe I should have thrown her back.
Daddy!
So sharp! Where have you been, you naughty girl? I was just about to be looking everywhere for you.
Is Mummy very cross?
Well, she did have a bit of a cob on, yes.
Oh dear. Still, never mind. The party's not to take her mind off things, won't it?
Oh yes, you mean the visit of what's it and what's her face?
Desert Sunrise and Golden Mountain.
That's what I said, wasn't it?
Dean Daddy, you're so funny.
Yes, I know. Anyway, where have you been? Your mother told you not to lag behind.
Nowhere special.
All right, don't tell me then. See if I care. I'm just the Emperor. And your father to boot. I don't really count, do I?
Oh, Daddy, you're right. I can't have any secrets from you, can I?
No.
I met a rather nice young man.
What, in this dump? On his holidays, is he?
No, he lives here. His mother runs a launch around the corner.
What for?
What do you mean?
Well, why does she run the laundry around the corner? Why doesn't she just take it down to the river and bash it with big rocks like everybody else?
No, she runs a laundry.
Oh, I see. Oh, well, a son-in-law from the private sector is not unheard of. Your mother and I were not in the same class. In fact, we went to different schools altogether.
That's what I like about you, Daddy. I love you even when I haven't a clue what you're talking about.
Oh, well, I know what I mean, and that's the main thing.
Why don't you go on back to the palace? I'll be there presently.
Oh, all right, so shy. I trust you. But don't be late. And don't tell your mother.
I will.
Aladdin!
Aladdin, were you hiding in the bushes the whole time? Oh, you didn't take what I was saying to my father seriously, I hope.
Of course not, so shy. What we say to our parents is one thing, what we say to each other is another thing entirely.
Is it Aladdin? Really?
Of course. It's not as though we're actually in love or anything, is it?
No, of course not.
The Emperor's daughter!
Grab that boy!
What's all this noise? What's it? Who? You must be the young man my daughter told me about. Pleased to meet you.
Off with his head!
Yes, off with your head. What? talk to your daughter's boyfriend?
You heard me. No one is allowed to see the face of the Emperor's daughter. Now off with his head.
But Mother, he's my friend.
Yeah, be reasonable, darling. A girl has to find some friends somewhere, doesn't she?
Oh, husband, when will I make you see? My daughter is the daughter of an emperor, as I am too.
Yes, told you, we'll never hear the end of that.
This boy must be made an example of. Now, guards, do your duty.
Oh, that cuts on this locomotion. I'm just trying to get 40 winks. I've only managed to get 23. I mean, I need my beauty sleep, you know.
You don't need beauty sleep. You need a plastic surgeon.
Who said that? Oh, you rude people. I tell you, I happen to be a model in adverts for baby powder when I was a baby.
With a face like that?
My face didn't come into it.
The buttocks didn't work.
Silence, woman. You are in the presence of the Emperor.
Oh, pleased to meet you, mate.
Do not address him as mate. Just kneel down.
Oh, pleased to meet you, Mr. Down. I may have called him Neil.
Woman, did anyone ever tell you that you are a fool, an imbecile, and an idiot?
No, not all at the same time, no, but... Hey, Aladdin, what are you doing down there?
He is to be executed.
Ooh! Oh, he's such a clever boy. Always gets to say he's be an executive one day. He is a clever boy.
Not executive, executed for seeing the face of the Emperor's daughter.
Oh, that is just a silly rule. I mean, all the people here have seen her face. And so has everybody out there as well.
Yeah. She does have a point, darling.
The sight is barbaric. If I was the emperor, I wouldn't allow it. Why is it that no one will see my face anyway? Am I so ugly?
Oh, of course not, my child. Of course not. You're the most beautiful daughter that a father ever fathered.
Or a mother ever mothered.
Mm. Or a grandmother ever grandmothered.
Oh, yes, all right. Don't labour the point. The point is, so shy. What's the point, darling?
Oh, the point is, my witless wonder of a husband, is that there is not one man in the whole of China that is worthy of so shy's hand. All this riffraff of peasants.
Well, who's she
no
supposed...
match for the daughter of an emperor.
Well, okay. I'm glad you got that line out. Who's she going to marry? Who's she going to marry then anyway? Old camel's nose.
If I was the emperor, I would let my daughter marry someone she loved and who loved her too.
Yes.
So would I. Ow. Gods, take the emperor's daughter from this place. I will not have her hobnobbing with peasants.
Aladdin! Oh, don't worry, sweetheart. I've been in worse scrapes before. I'll see you later. You know where I'll be.
Stop!
Effective, ain't I? I bet you not. And I wasn't going to show up, didn't you? Well, here I am! So come on, let's go! Rubbish! You haven't got a clue how bad I am, have you? Come on, let's hear it! That's a bit more like it. And now, to business! Which one of these peasants is Aladdin, I wonder?
Transport, you know, and I still don't know my stage directions. Oh, it's ready! My latest invention! The cheeseless mousetrap!
Excuse me, young man. Is there something we can do for you? I'm rather busy here, if you must know.
Why? Who are you?
My name is... Oh, it's irrelevant.
Oh, pleased to meet you, Mr. Relevant. What's the E stand for?
Ha, ha, ha. I can see I was right about him the first time I saw him. A poltroon with a nugatory intelligence.
Yeah, I do know lots about sweets.
Enough of that now, lad. I seek a boy. Maybe you can help.
Me? Okay.
His name is Aladdin.
Aladdin? Oh, what do you want with him? Oh, what's he done now?
So far, nothing. But once I find him, I can promise him great riches.
Oh, that's good enough for me. That's Aladdin there.
Being held down by the Emperor's guard. Oh, I wonder if I should try and help him.
No.
Oh, don't worry about that now.
Wishy!
I'll soon have this little problem ironed out.
Ironed? Oh, iron, that reminds me. I've got to help Mum in the laundry.
Good boy, well done. By the way, that cheeseless mousetrap thingy of yours.
Yeah?
How does it work?
Oh, simple. Instead of a hacksaw blade, there's a ricksaw blade. You understand?
Yes, I understand.
The mouse comes up to the blade, looks over the top and says, "Where's all the flipping cheese gone then?" And then it saws off its own head.
Clever boy. I'll have to watch out for him. People of Chinatown, I come from the mystical, I bring you magic from the Orient.
No, you mean Leighton Orient? Oh, they have been doing well. Top of the Mission 1, weren't they? Anyway, who are you?
My name is... Oh, let's not go through all that again. I am Abanaza.
Abanaza?
Abanaza. I come from the mystical East.
Oh, you mean Eastbourne.
Enough of this nonsense. You, Ebenezer.
No, Abanaza.
Ababanana.
Copacabana.
This is getting us nowhere fast.
If I could interject, miss.
Oh, very well, carry on.
As I was saying, I bring you magic from the Orient.
Ooh, tricks! I love tricks!
Gather round, my friend. Gather round and join me in the shared space that is your village high street. You, sir.
Yes. It's the wrong cup.
It's the Ace of Spades.
Oh dear, you seem to have got the wrong card. Okay, you sir, card.
Yes, oh that's it.
The Nine of Clubs.
Yes, oh,
am I right?
He's good, isn't he? Well, not really, but he's quite good. I didn't even know I picked that card.
It's all in the mind, you see.
Well, that was the case, maybe.
Ah, oh, Mr. Alabama, may I try one, please?
Have a nozzle.
No, thank you, I don't.
For you, the Queen of Hearts.
Ooh.
You're my type. Join me in my caravan, Lisa.
Oh, no, I don't think I can. My husband wouldn't understand.
Oh, don't bring him.
Well, tricks are all very well, Abanaza, but what brings you to our little village? Entertain visitors.
I'm not surprised. You're a funny lot. I'll give you that.
Hey.
Well, Mr. Aladdin.
You know my name.
I know many things. Including my lines at some point. How about you? Oh, yes, I do. And I will prove it now if you give it a chance. Right. I know many things, and I will tell all, given time.
Do you know you remind me of someone? Are you an only child?
No, not now that I'm a grown-up, no.
No, I mean brothers or sisters.
Wait now. There was a brother back along. A rover! A handsome rogue of a man, with an eye for the ladies too. Perhaps you knew him. His name was...
Brian! 20!
You knew my
Moon O'Brien, ever the daredevil. He came to a sticky end, trying to jump 20 motorcycles whilst riding on the back of an elephant.
A curious trial. I did once hear a man who tried to jump 20 elephants on a motorcycle. Yes.
It was a shame that Brian hadn't heard of that man.
What is it that brings you to China, Uncle?
I must admit that the journey was not only to my benefit. Your late father left you a legacy.
A legacy? What colour is it?
Mother, calm down. What's the legacy, Uncle?
All in good time, Aladdin. But first, let's you and I go somewhere a little more private.
My mother told me to never go anywhere with strange men.
I am not a strange man.
No, yes, you are.
Oh, no, I'm not.
No, yes, you are.
I am your late father's brother. I'm almost like one of the family.
I suppose you are. Right, Uncle.
Good boy. Now let's leave these peasants to their simple pleasures. You and I have bigger fish to fry.
Dustman Pat!
Leon! The streets!
Who is it now? I thought everyone was here.
Your illustrious cousins, Alice. Desert Sunrise and Gold Mountain.
Hello, gorgeous.
How do we find you? Good journey?
Robbed! Robbed? Is that all Camelot's brother?
Be quiet, you fool! Who could have done this?
Strangers attacked our caravan! Desperate men! Some miles and all of them escaped with our honour intact!
Well, you know, I reckon the camels were in more trouble.
Gods! How could this have happened? Is it not safe for the Emperor's family to walk safely in the streets of this town?
Well, now, it do depend which street you mean. Some are underwater at the moment, and if you live in the furlongs, well, I'm saying that.
Yeah. Stay along, why you wouldn't last 5 minutes.
Don't worry, wouldn't you see dead down your way?
No, you're right, actually, there's no street lights.
My dear cousins, you've obviously had a terrible shock. Now, what I'd really like to do now is go to the George and get completely rattled. Hey. Before we do that, I think we should retire to the palace for some traditional Chinese hospitality.
Oh, yes. What did you have in mind?
More tea and biscuits.
Oh.
Chinese tea, no need to stand on ceremony, eh? Well, some folk put much reliance on politics and science. But there's only one hero for me. In praise we should be roaring, the man who thought of pouring the first boiling water onto tea. 2, 3, I like a nice cup of tea in the morning. Time to start the day, you see. At 11:30, my idea of heaven is a nice cup of tea. I like a nice
Uncle, I think it's time that we left.
Okay.
Come on,
yes, we can go.
say yes, please. Earl Grey?
Yes, please.
Earl Grey?
Yes, please.
I say Assam. You say lovely. Assam?
Lovely.
Assam?
Lovely.
And I say ooh. You say long. Ooh?
Long.
Ooh?
Long.
I like a nice cup of tea in the morning. Got to start the day, you see. And I'm past 11. My idea of heaven is a nice cup of tea. I like a nice cup of tea.
Maybe it was no then.
I shall read it and prove my superior intelligence.
If you can.
It's quite clear to me actually what's expected of us.
What's that?
Well, before we do anything else.
Yes?
Sing a song.
No,
later. And you're here with me, Trevor. Don't worry.
We need to actually find someone.
We do. In the back.
And then in the winter, I asked you to chop some wood.
I had to go out and buy a whole new table and chairs.
Roll on spring, eh, Mum?
No, Wishy, you have to accept facts. You're a daft as a brush. You only got that electric lawnmower so you could find your way home.
Aww.
Oh!
No, you just
anyway, don't worry. While you're here, you can probably help me.
What, with your line?
Yeah, with my line. Look, I'll tell you what. I've got something in my laundry that does the work of five men.
Five men?
Yeah.
What? Five men? What is it?
A woman! Brother Aladdin, anyway, he's such a good boy.
He's such a good boy to his mother. Yeah, because he never comes home, Mum.
Well, last time I saw him, he was with his uncle Abracadabra, I think.
Abenaza, Mum.
No, thank you, I've just had one. Anyway, while you're here, as I said, you should help me with my washi. You can get on the end of this line.
Why, Mum? I'm not wet.
Well, that's a matter of opinion, I reckon. Anyway, look here, get on with that.
Come on. Was that the door?
Yeah, go and see who it is.
All right, Mum.
Oh, must have been the wind. Where'd you get that?
You gave it to me.
Oh, well, did you give it back to me?
I don't think so.
Oh, anyway, look, why not? Tie these two together, will you? Come on.
All right.
Go and see who that is.
All right, Mum.
Sorry, excuse me. Where'd you get that from? I mean, there's something wrong here. I've got three ends now. Go and see who that is.
Oh, that way.
Oh, my goodness me. This is ridiculous. I've got four ends now. Look, you take these two. Come on, take those two. I'll take these two, and somehow we'll meet in the middle. That way, we'll make ends meet, eh?
Oh, okay.
Woo!
Mummy! Mum!
Geordies. Well, we thought you might hand on in
curtains. Yeah, well, I'm not going to let you two idiots do it. You fall out the window.
Oh, go on. Give us a chance.
Oh, okay, I'll try out. You can load the washing machine and you can load the tumble dryers.
Oh, Mrs. Drake, I think we can do that, all right?
Yes, indeed, load the washing machine.
Load the tumble dryers.
Just one thing before we start.
Yes?
Where'd you eat the bullets?
See, I told you! They're nothing but a pair of idiots! I don't know why you employ them.
Mum, be quiet! Shush! They're cheap!
Well, that one is. What about Cheerful Charlie over there?
Oh,
excuse
me,
excuse me. Didn't he take an intelligence test last week?
Oh, he did!
And what did he get on it?
Triple.
Exactly! Oh, I don't know why you employ them, I really don't. Look, go and get the baskets. Go and get them twice, if you like.
Okay.
Go on.
I can't get them twice, I'm just
too much running. All right, now we're getting
some. I found some bullets.
I want a fortune cookie. Oh, we've run out of fortune cookies. Anyway, okay. Now, you load washing machine number one.
Washing machine go. Number one.
Right, go. And you. You load tumble dryer number one. Go on.
Which one's the tumble dryer?
Tumble dryer's there, go on.
Okay.
Now we're getting somewhere. You got a switch on.
Switch on?
Yes, switch on, you know.
Switch on?
Switch on. Go on.
Oh, the switch! I'll turn this. All right, Mum, I'm doing it. Mum!
One Direction as well. He always did like a bit of flattery. Now he's legless. Poor boy. I'll have to stitch him up, pump him up. He'll be fine later on. Not a problem. Bye-bye.
Shai's father that you were worthy of his daughter's hand in marriage?
But it's not him I need to persuade.
Ah yes, the Empress too. Well, you know how rich people are influenced by money. They think of nothing else.
Well, I'm not like that. I don't want So Shai to marry me just because I'm rich. I want her to marry me because she loves me.
Oh, love, yes. And love you she does, Aladdin. Believe me, I can tell. I know women, but equally, the Emperor's, Soshai's parents need,
the next line.
A hard cash in order for the marriage. The hard cash in order for the marriage to be approved. It's the way of the world, I'm afraid. And it's what's written in the script as well.
Maybe the treasure could be useful in other ways too. Mother really deserves a break from doing people's laundry all day long. I wish he could use some investment capital for some of his inventions.
I'm not so sure that that's such a good idea. For Wishy, anyway. But what would you do with your share of the treasure, Aladdin?
I would talk to Mark Wadlow about a portfolio of shares.
Shares? Share? Oh, her latest CD, you mean? Well, she has sung some pretty nice songs over the years. I particularly like that Shoop Shoop one. Don't you, Russ? Now, come on. Watch me open the cave.
It's lopsided.
It's lopsided?
It's a lopsided cave.
It's a lopsided cave. Oh, dear. Well, anyway. Oh!
What's the matter?
Cave lopsided. No, I've forgotten the password.
What?
The password.
It was a finger.
The entrance to the cave is protected by a magic spell, and it can only be opened by the utterance of a secret password.
Please.
Well, how can you have forgotten something as important as that?
Come to think of it, I don't think I ever knew it.
Well, now what are we going to do?
Let me think about this. There must be somebody who knows what it is.
I know. What about the boys and girls?
What? That lot? They don't know anything.
Uncle, you've got to learn to have a little more faith in the audience. How about it, boys and girls? Do you know what the password is?
Yes! Sesame!
What's that?
Yes! Sesame!
No, no, they're saying shop at the apiary. Oh.
Why?
What's that?
Open Sesame!
Oh, Open Sesame! All right, well, let's give it a try then, shall we?
Yeah.
Open Sesame! There. Nothing.
That didn't work.
Told you so.
Shall I have a go?
You? Wait a minute. The Pharaoh did say that only Aladdin could own the lamp, so maybe he's the only one who can open the cave. Very well, my boy, by all means, you have a go.
Okay. Open, Bank Holiday Monday?
No, that wasn't it. What was it now?
Wasn't it something about food?
Yes, I think it was.
Sesame seed bars.
Yes, that's right.
Open sesame seed bars!
That's the sort of thing you get in McDonald's, isn't it?
Yeah.
Anyway, you have a go. Go on.
What, open sesame seed bar?
Yeah. No, something to do with food, I think. I don't think it was open sesame seed bar.
Open shredded wheat.
No, that wasn't it. What was it now?
Open sesame!
Open sesame!
Thank you so much. Thank you.
I think we better go for it now, Lenny.
Okay. Open sesame!
Well done. In you go. Try not to think about the rats.
Okay, Uncle, in I go.
No!
In he goes.
Coming out again, what if there's a great big spider in there?
Well, what if there is? Do you want me to go back down to town to tell So Shy that you're scared of spiders?
Would you?
Aladdin, go into that cave at once, I command you. It is your destiny.
I know, I could have just done with a bit more notice, that's all. Why did you have to tell me about the rats?
Wait a minute, I have an idea. This ring was given to me by the Pied Piper of Hamelin, whom I met at a wedding once. It's guaranteed to keep away the rats. Wear it and you will be safe in the cave. Happy now?
Okay, thanks, Uncle. In I go.
In he goes.
You say?
Yes, the one and only.
What was he doing at the wedding?
The marriage had to be ratified. Now, will you go in?
Okay, Uncle, in I go.
In he goes. Soon the sacred lamp will be in my hand. Oh, I can hardly wait. Until wealth, until power, soon it will all be mine. And then I see stand against me, and I shall rule the world!
Well, boy, what can you see?
I can't see a thing. I need a torch or something.
warn you, boy. Don't try my patience. I know your little game. You just want all the treasure for yourself, don't you?
No, honestly, I really can't see a thing. Let me come back up, please.
I should, Coco. You stay down there until you find the lamp.
There's a lamp down here, but why didn't you say? Where is it?
When you're down there, you tell me.
Oh, hang on, Uncle. I'm just feeling for a switch.
A switch? Why? Oh, you half-wit. I mean an oil lamp.
Look, it's no good, Uncle. I can't find it. Let me come back up, please. I think I can hear the rats coming.
I've already told you, Aladdin. You'll stay down there until you find the treasure. I haven't come this far just to be thwarted by the likes of a guttersnipe like you.
But I'm not doing it on purpose, Uncle. Really, I can't see a thing. Let me come back up, please.
Well, maybe this time tomorrow your eyes will have become accustomed to the gloom. I couldn't open the cave, but let's see if I can close it. Good night, Aladdin. See you in the morning, and make sure you've got the lamp.
Sacred lamp?
What, this?
Yes!
be as valuable as all of those precious jewels.
Well, why not give it a rock, Master?
What, again?
Yeah, go on.
Who is it that dares to face the mighty genie of the lamp? And as a footling mortal, fist waves of vicious flea?
No, genie, I just want to get out of this cave. After that, you're free to get back to your lamp.
What is this? A human that does not seek wealth and power? In all my thousands of years, I have not met such a one. Your name, boy?
My name's Aladdin. What's yours?
Ah, yes. My name, let's see. Yes, I did have one once. It's been so long since I used it.
I sympathise. I'm the same with my pin number.
Wait! I have it!
My pin number? That's a good trick.
No. My name. I remember it now. It's Al Itty.
Ality. Geniality. Are you sure?
Reasonably sure, yes.
All right, then,
Aladdin,
how about it? Can you get me out of this cave?
More than that, Aladdin. I can give you the riches and power to do anything that you want.
But what good are riches and power to me? I'm just a poor boy.
An attitude that does you credit, my boy. But a poor boy with treasure is, in fact, a rich boy. The power comes later, you understand?
But what good is it?
What good is power? Why, this power, you can do whatever you want!
You mean marry so shy?
Slave, translate if you will. I have not used my ears for several centuries.
Aladdin, love a girl, the Emperor of China's daughter, the Lady So Shy.
Yes. There's always a girl, isn't there? With the riches and power I can bring you, you will be free to marry the girl that you love. What more could a poor boy wish for? Think about it, Aladdin. Shall we? To China?
All right, me old China. Let's see you do it.
I do that too, yes. I do
that
too.
It hurts, doesn't it?
Yes. Do I do it with poetry?
Oh, go on then.
Rocks and stones of ages past, though your walls are thick and vast. Back to town we need to travel by carpet, and I hope it don't unravel.
Okay, I'll promise me one thing.
Yes?
No more poetry.
You don't like my poetry? My poetry is my gift.
Well, when given a gift, it's the thought that counts.
You don't like it.
No.
Think, yes. Oh. It's very sad for this German genie, is it not? Yes. Yes, it's sad, but think what it's been like for me, secreted in the lamp all these years. It gets boring, you understand. Yes, yeah. Aladdin, the magic carpet.
my mother and father will never allow a lad to be married. I suppose I'm just dreaming. You are
explanation.
Oh, yes.
Hey, good as we've got all that sorted out. Now we can get on.
You mean to say that all this is but a small token of your esteem?
Jeannie, I think you've impressed the Empress.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Paddy! There you are, you naughty boy! I've been looking everywhere for you. I've been worried sick.
It's
a long story, Mother.
Well, don't tell me now. I just want to know who your friend is. Here
you are. Ah, I am the genie of the lamp, Miss. But you can call me Anne.
Jeannie, why don't you show Mum what you can do?
Of this poetry?
Go on then.
Dear lady, I'm not one to gloat, but I can improve on this shabby coat. This spell is just for Widow Twanky. New clothes!
Right.
Right down to her golden hanky.
Rain roses are so shiny, so you don't have to go in the mud. Sorry. It's to make the food go round, so everyone gets a bit.
Oh, I see. So how far have you got?
Oh, shit.
Those poor people at Follow's Manor.
I know, Follow's Manor. Can you imagine?
Okay, okay, well, I'm good.
Just remember, it's a panto, not the Cirque du Soleil. Oh, yes it is.
No illusion, anyway.
We can do stuff with it.
Oh, with that son of mine! Honestly, boys, never there when you need them.
We thought he was down the laundry, Mrs. Twanky.
We did.
Yeah, he was, but he's not anymore. Well, what are you doing with those plates?
Oh, we're spinning them, Mrs. Twanky.
Spinning plates? Whatever for?
Well, that's when we have people round for dinner, Mrs. Twanky.
Oh, you think they'd rather have a square meal instead, wouldn't you?
Well, we don't know, Mrs. Twanky.
We don't even think, Mrs. Twanky, most of the time.
No. Oh. Anyway, look, while I'm out, let me help. Come on, I'm good at spinning. Oh yes, I spun a yarn the other day.
In that case, you have these two, be careful, don't get them under balance. Careful. Just balance, the balance, the balance. And I'll get two more.
No, you can't,
you
two are cheating. Both hands, not just one. Just showing off. What are we going to do now?
I'll have a look on my list. Oh hang on, I'll get
what's the matter?
Well, the list is in my pocket, right? And I can't get my hand in my pocket without dropping coins.
Oh, okay, right.
I'll get it for you!
No, that's not a good idea, because if you get it, your plates will start spinning and they'll fall.
Okay then. Ooh. How about you get it? That'll work.
Oh, no, that's not good. If I get it, then my plates will fall.
fault as well.
You've got a good idea.
I know,
tell me, Tearful, what's a good idea?
Are you ready? This is whispering really good. If I take my shoes off, I can spin one of your plates with my foot, and then you can get this with our free hands.
That's a good idea.
No, it isn't. If you take your shoes off, then your plates will stop spreading. And that falls.
Oh.
I'll tell you what, I've got it.
Okay.
I'll take my shoes and socks off, and then
genius.
I can...
Genius in the making.
Oh no, it's not a good idea! Hey, your place will stop smelling and they fall as well!
Oh,
right, oh goodness gracious! This is ridiculous! Is there anybody back there that can help us here?
Hello!
Hello, miss!
Hello! Hello.
No, just over there! Yeah.
That's it!
Oh, it reminds me of when I was in prison! All right, what's it say then? Oh, it's no good. I still can't read. Shirt to Cheerful.
You must be joking. I'm a bloke. I can't multitask. Show
it to
me. Oh, let's have a look. No, I can't read it either. Oh. Tell me, what does it say?
It says, stop spinning the plates.
That was a waste of time. Look, let's go down the pub.
Can we go to the George?
Oh, I meant Smuggler's.
Oh, I like Smuggler's.
Why don't you come to Ruffini and have a glass of wine?
Oh, you're joking! They won't be ready till 2017!
Oh, there you are, cousins! I was beginning to think they left the palace!
Why would we do that so shy?
Oh, come on, you can tell me. Don't you both have a little crush on our two boys in blue?
You mean Bing and Pong?
Well, I must admit, they do look quite dishy in their uniforms.
So, Shy, you're a girl. Tell us, how do you get boys to notice you?
I don't know. It just happens, I suppose, if it's meant to be.
Do you think it's meant to be us and Bing and Pong?
Well, here they come now. Why don't you ask them?
Who? Ask us what?
I'll leave you alone. Just remember, be yourselves.
Oh, we were just wondering if you boys have got any time off.
Leave?
Yeah, very well. Be like that. We didn't fancy you anyway.
Now, ladies!
Ladies! Let me explain. Time off, we call leave. And yeah, we do. Well, I do. Fancy you, big boy, that is.
What's okay then?
Look at those two canoodling like a couple of teenagers. Makes me think.
That must pass.
It does, mate. It makes me think. We should be doing the same, come here.
You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain. Too much love drives a man insane. You broke my will.
Thank you.
Someone's doing all right.
My cousin lured me. His name is Aladdin.
Aladdin? Never heard of him. I'm a stranger around these parts.
Stranger? Wait a minute. You look familiar. I recognise you from somewhere.
Here it is.
No, you must have.
At last, the secret lamp is in my hand. Genie of the lamp. I am your master. I command you to transport this palace and all within it to the land of the Pharaoh.
I see we have a change of ownership.
Never mind the fat chat, you lethargic lamp dweller. Obey me at once. That is your function.
Very well. No! Though I'd rather have a mint arrow, transport this palace to the land of the Pharaoh.
And no more poetry.
Philistine, you're no fun.
Know your place and do my bidding.
Consider it done, Ebenezer. But be warned, this is not over yet.
Thank you.
You wait till my lad invites you, brute, then you'll be in trouble.
Ah, you mean the penniless Chinese street rat? Somehow I don't see him being able to cross the ocean, the desert, and negotiate all the potholes and the flooding in the high street. Come and rescue you, my dear. Why not forget about it and marry me?
I'd rather die.
Gods! Wait, take her to my chambers. I have guests arriving. I'll see you later.
Yeah. Hello, boys and girls!
Hey. We should calm down, remember why we're here.
Oh, right, yeah. Oh, come on, in one time.
Well done, Jeannie, for getting us here in the first place.
Oh, you can call me Jeannie until I'm blue in the face. But I'm just a slave. Anyway, you must remember that the ring hasn't got as much powerfulness as the sacred lamp.
Well, Aladdin, what are we going to do now we're here?
What we need to do is create a diversion.
Oh, good. I'll go and put some cones out.
No. Oh, diversion, Mum.
Oh, come on. Oh, someone's coming. Let's hide.
Oh, come on. Come on, you. Come on.
Can you see anyone?
What's the matter with your throat?
Nothing is the matter with my throat!
Oh, whispering.
Oh, I see.
So, can you see anyone?
Yeah.
Who?
You.
I don't count, numbskull. Can you see anyone else?
Oh, I don't know, hang on. Yeah.
Oh.
Me.
You don't count either.
Yeah, I do. I got an A in maths once.
We're not here to talk about your proficiency in maths. We need to find the girls. So come on, follow me.
Right then.
On second thoughts, I'll follow you.
Now, may we present a gentleman, the merchant daughter.
I see how beautiful she is. But she is sad, however. As she got no one to love or take care of her. I see how sad she is. Honourable guest, may we now present to her the merchant gardener. He have a love in his heart for Jasmine, but he think it can never be. Each night, he creep into the ground and sink softly up at her window, hoping to wake her from her sleep. Honourable guest, her hand does succeed in waking Jasmine one night, and under a magical moon, they dance and fall in love. Honourable guest, I regret to have to tell you the merchant child hid a lover and vowed that her will never marry. Oh, Jasmine, a lamentable heartbreak for our two lovers. What they should do? Honourable guest, our lover hatch a plan. One night when the merchant sleep, by the light of the full moon, her will come for Jasmine and carry her away. What excitement! Honourable guest, our lover flee into the night, but the child hear them escaping and give a chase. He carry a sword, the poor heart he is useless. They must make it across the tie and over the white wood and the bridge, or goodness knows what will happen. Honourable guest, I regret to have to tell you, our lover did not make it over the bridge. Aww. In the final moment, Chao catch up with our two lover, and catching hold of her, I slew him before Jasmine's very eye. Jasmine, try in vain to stop her father, but she not strong enough. In the midst of the fray, she slipped and fell from the bridge into the raging cookmere below. Never to be seen or heard from again.
Lunch.
Honourable guest, huh? Jasmine, I left this land for a better place. A place where they could be happy together. And in her father's land, they came to nest a pair of white lovebirds. The bird we call the dove, a universal sign of peace and love, still to this day. Thank you.
Well, it's not exactly EastEnders, is it?
Still, it passes the time. What have we got next, I wonder?
Genie?
Yeah, master?
Genie!
Aladdin, how did you get here?
Such a touching reunion. However, I think you'll find that the genie belongs to me now. Genie, get rid of these vermin. Your master commands you.
I'm sorry, Aladdin. I must obey.
I understand, genie, but I think your master has forgotten something.
What? What's that you say?
I thought it was power you were searching for. If so, it seems to me that you have failed.
Aladdin, what are you doing?
Oh, sorry. Aladdin's right, Mother. Abanaza has no power.
But the genie has all the power, right, genie?
I'm afraid to tell you, the genie does exactly as I say.
So why are we still here? Don't you see? In order for you to be as powerful as you wish, you have to become a genie, and that you can never do. Slave, could you make me a genie?
Alas, Master, no can do. My powers are not strong enough!
You see? Your simpering slave, wherever he is, has as much power as my genie does in his little finger.
I'll bet he's not powerful enough to make you a genie, though.
Oh, yeah? Genie, I command you at once to make me a genie.
Consider it done, Abanaza.
There you are, you see? I have all the power of the cosmos, and it is mine! I am a genie! I do not need you anymore. Oh. My powers are infinite!
Oh, what do you mean?
Yes, and also the same with your very own brand new lap. In you go!
No!
Well, when you have to live on your wits, you pick up all kinds of tricks.
But now you have the lamp that makes you my master.
No, Genie, I have everything I need. My friends and family too. It's time I set you free from this old lamp.
Free? You're setting me free?
Not just you. Slave, I've got one last request of you.
Master?
Take this lamp back to the cave where we found the old one and place it on the rock, carefully, so that nothing should accidentally rub against it. After that, you're free to go.
Free, Master? I won't know what to do with myself.
You can come with me, Slave. We can travel, see a bit of the world, maybe the Vaseland, Berlin, something like that.
Oh, well, okay.
Oh. That reminds me, I have a new use for the ring. So shall I wait a long time to ask for this? I've crossed oceans and deserts for you. Finally, will you marry me? Oh.
la la la.